Now let's move ahead with the looping concepts in Node. The basic program we are covering in the initial videos, just to be handy with the Node.js, you should be able to handle the Visual Studio Code properly. You should be aware about the syntaxes of Node.js, and then we'll actually move towards the modular structure of Node. So now we're going to understand the looping programs. So let's add one more file. Let's name it 12.js and declare one variable for I equals 1, I less than equal to 10, I plus plus. This will run this for loop from 1 to 10. What I'll do inside is I'll put the value of I into a string with some space, and after the completion of for loop, I'll print this string to the console. So what will happen here is the loop will start from 1 and go up to 10 with the iteration of 1. I am concatenating the value of 1 to 10 into a string variable, and which is getting printed to the console. Now let's run it. Node 12.js, and we'll see the output as 1 to 10. So it printed the values from 1 to 10. So this is again similar to the C language or other programming language, traditional programming language that you might be using. It has all the similar loops available, including the for each and while and so on. So you can tweak with those loops and try to understand the process of the iteration. Now do one more program into this. So let's name it as 13.js and let's work on that part. Let's write it where, let's put some initial value while it's less than equal to 10, then string plus equal is for concatenating the stuff into the string. So and then plus plus coming outside the loop, and let's console.log and print this string. Now let's try to execute this program and see whether it behaves the same way we are expecting. Node 13.json, yes, it has printed the values from 1 to 10. So these are the basic structure of programming structure of Node.js. So if you have the programming fundamentals clear, you can very easily work with the Node.js. And once you are habitual to the syntaxes of Node.js, it is very easy to work with any JavaScript framework that is available across. So from here on, we'll move towards the more modular structure of Node.js from our upcoming session. So stay tuned. Thanks.